What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and you just saw a quick unboxing on Lenovo's ThinkPad P17 Generation 1 workstation laptop. So what comes inside the box? So let's start here. We have our safety and warranty guide. Cool. We have our ThinkPad P17 Generation 1 setup guide. Pretty awesome. We have our heavy gauge power cable. And we have our 230 watts power adapter. So I'm actually going to take the power cable right now, hook it up to the power adapter. Awesome. Let's put all this stuff to the side. And then we have the beautiful Lenovo ThinkPad P17 Generation 1 workstation. Now this guy actually weighs around 7.75 pounds with a thickness of 1.28 inches. Now for ports and features, there are a lot of ports and features. On the right hand side, you have one SD card reader. You have two 3.2 USB ports. On the left hand side, you have your audio combo jack. You have a nano SIM tray, and that's optional. It really depends on how you set it up on the Lenovo site. You have one 3.2 USB always on charging port. And last but not least, you have your HDMI port. Now on the backhand side, you have an RJ45, one Type-C port, two Type-C port Thunderbolt 3, which actually supports external monitors. And then last but not least, your power port. All right, so we're gonna open up the P17 Generation 1 workstation from Lenovo. We're gonna power it on. We're gonna look at some of the specs on this particular machine, how the performance was when I was using it, and let's get into that. All right, so we just went over some of the ports and features on the ThinkPad P17 Generation 1 workstation from Lenovo. So let's open this guy up and turn it on. So let's open this guy up. Ooh, look at that beautiful display. All right, so to power it on, the power button is actually located right here. We're gonna turn it on, awesome. All right, to log in, you have multiple ways to log in. On the P17, you actually have a fingerprint scanner right here, and you're also able to hook it up with Windows Hello. I'm actually gonna log in with my fingerprint, so boom, and you're done, awesome. Okay, so on the P17 Gen 1, let's talk about the trackpad. Now the trackpad, it's pretty decent. I didn't have any issues using it. The majority of the time, I just basically hooked up a USB mouse and just used that. But like the response on the trackpad, it just works. I didn't have any issues at all. Now, if you want to know the measurement, if you take one quarter, one nickel, one penny, and two dimes, that's actually going to measure around 3.98 inches. So it has a nice, you know, a nice size for you to do what you need to do on this particular trackpad. Now for the keyboard in the P17, it is a full keyboard layout, which gives you the number pad on your right hand side, which is awesome. Using this particular keyboard, I did not have any issues at all. Now the key distance between each key is around 0.12 inches and it is backlit with a couple of settings. So that works great with no problem. Now the speaker system on the P17 is actually located at the very top of the keyboard. It's pretty loud. I think the loudest that I got was around 93.6 decibels, which is not that bad. Now for the display, we are rocking a 17.3 inch IPS anti-glare display on the P17. It's non-touch, which is a huge plus for me. I don't like laptops, it's touchscreen. Now the resolution of the P17 is around 3840 by 2160. The brightness level right now, I think this is the highest right now in the brightness. And this is the lowest. If you guys want to know, the nicked number is around 500. Now this machine does have HDR, but the HDR is basically when you're streaming HDR video online. So that option is there. The refresh rate for this machine is around 60. For scaling, by default, it is set to 250%, which is the default. I felt like the best scaling for this particular machine was around 200%. At the very top of the 17.3 display, you have a 720 webcam, and the webcam actually has a privacy guard, which is super simple to actually open and close. So I didn't have any issues on that, which is pretty good. Again, this machine, you are able to configure Windows Hello. You could just slide this guy to your right to open it, and then you're able to log in with your face. And you know, and close it back up, and then you're good to go. All right, so we just went over the trackpad, the keyboard, the webcam, and the beautiful 17.3 inch display that the P17 Generation 1 ThinkPad has. Okay, so let's talk about the specifications. Now, I was super happy with the specifications that Lenovo sent me. Now, if I right click on the taskbar and let's go inside Task Manager. Within Task Manager, I'm going to click on More Detail. Let's go to Performance. Let's open this guy up a little bit. Let's right click on the CPU, change the graph to logical processors. Whoa. Now, this guy has one socket, 8 cores, 16 logical processors. And it's running an Intel Xeon W1085M processor with a clock speed of 2.40 gigahertz. Now for memory, this machine actually came with 32 gigs, which is enough for everything that I needed to do. I am able to bump it up even more. I did have VM workstation dealing with a bunch of virtual machines, but if 32 gigs is enough for my day-to-day stuff. Now for hard drive space, it only came with one 512 gigabyte solid state drive, which is good for me. And for the graphics card, it came with an NVIDIA Quadro RTX 5000. Now, this machine with this particular graphics card, when gaming and doing video editing, it just worked with no problem. I was able to actually edit 4K within Premiere without creating any proxies. It was just amazing. I was able to use DaVinci doing my coloring because of the display and everything. It just worked with no problem. I love this machine. It's really heavy, so it's one of those things that you actually have to set up in your desktop and just forget it, but that's okay. Now for heating, I noticed that there's a lot of heating in this area right here. There's a lot of vents for the P17. There's a vent on your right hand side, left hand side, as well at the bottom to keep it nice and cool. But when I measure the heating, it was always around this area right here, and it's between 98 to 102 degrees, so it does get hot. I did not notice any fan noise. Probably I just didn't pick it up, but for me, when I was testing out this machine, I just didn't get any fan noise with it at all. Now, for every laptop that I like to review for you guys, I like to run PC Mark 10. And as always, I like to run 3 tests, or maybe 4. And on the first test, I ran the modern office battery life. PC Mark 10, what it does is just constantly running multiple programs like Excel, PowerPoint, going online, surfing, and playing music until the battery completely runs out and the machine shuts down. Now, when I ran the office battery life, it lasts around 1 hour and 47 minutes. On my second test, I actually ran video battery life, and I was super surprised that it lasted an additional hour, total of 2 hours and 14 minutes, which is super crazy. And then last but not least, I had to try it out. I did some gaming, and it only took around 59 minutes only on gaming. So you definitely have to plug this guy up if you are gaming with that graphics card. It's just not going to be powerful. You need that extra power for the graphics card to perform the way that you want it to perform on this machine. All right, so let's conclude our review on the P17 Generation 1 workstation from Lenovo. Now, I forgot to tell you guys that this machine, you are able to go inside the firmware within the BIOS setting and configure it to either go discrete or hybrid. By default, it is set to discrete. And the only reason that I'm telling you guys that this option is available on this machine is that sometimes when you change it to a hybrid, a lot of people have stated that it will kind of give you a better performance on the battery. But within my testing with other laptops that had that setting, I didn't really see a big difference. Now, this machine, again, does have a lot of ports and features. You are able to hook up an HDMI monitor as well as a Type-C monitor as well. Unfortunately, I did not have a monitor with a Type-C cable. I had to use a Type-C to HDMI adapter to actually use those two ports behind the P17, which worked with no problem. Now, the starting retail price for this machine is around $1,300, but it really depends on how you configure it. I think the highest is around $2,200, and it all depends on the memory, the hard drive space, and the graphics card that you pick on this machine. Again, on the Lenovo site, you are able to configure the display. I think there's two flavors. You got the 4K model as well as the 1080p model. Now for the size, it is a monster. It is a beast. I don't really see myself traveling with this machine a lot. If I do travel with it, it's most likely I'm gonna set it up at the hotel room, plug it in, power it on, and just leave it be. Now, the P17 is super easy to upgrade its parts. Lenovo made it super easy for everyone. If you close the lid and just flip it, there is a compartment with one screw. Just unscrew it, open it up, and then you're going to see your DIMM slots, as well as an additional slot to insert a solid state drive, which is awesome. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review on the P17. I had a lot of fun actually testing this guy for you guys. Right now the battery is extremely going down. I think I have almost 67%. Again, you really have to plug this guy in to actually take advantage of the power, because the battery kind of runs out real quick. And I'm not really doing a lot on this machine with you guys, and it's already down 67%. That's crazy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.